My name is Harvansh and thank you for watching the other videos in the this series I am running about the prerequisite for lab, like how we can build our lab. So in my last two videos you have seen how you can install SQL server in VM, and the next video was how you can assign the right IP, like static IP that will be the fix for that particular server, and how you will get the internet access on your VM machine from your local machine. If you are having the internet access on your local machine like laptop or desktop, so how it will be passed to the VM. Okay, so now this video is about how we can install the Active Directory in lab. So let me start this video. First of all, you log in to the server and then click on the server manager and let it run now. Okay, so now add a role and the features. Now this screen you will get to before you log in. No need to read, no one basically is reading that. And here you can verify your the server name, because server name should be something unique. It should not be like the by default. In my last video only I showed you how you can change the host name, because it's necessary and it should be easy to remember that. Okay, so now click on next, and it will be a role based or the feature based installation. Now click on next. And here is a Active Directory domain services which we are going to select. Once you click on this, you will get this pop-up. So include all the features and click on next, click on next, click on next, and click on installed. So now this AD is getting installed. Why we are installing the Active Directory? Because to be building a lab, our machine should be in domain, and without AD it not at all possible. Your machine should be added in any domain. So that's why I am building now my AD server, and I want to show you guys how you can install your Active Directory server here. So let's watch this video and complete it, what it will install and how we can work on this part. Okay, so it will not take much time, it just will take a couple of minutes. So let's see if any error comes, so on the spot we can troubleshoot it. Okay, so now it's showing like confirmation required, installation succeeded on lab. On lab means this is my the host name. Now close it, and now click on yellow button, and here promote the server to a domain controller. So now this is for the Active Directory domain service configuration wizard. Okay, so that is installed, and now we are going to configure our domain name. So it's a like add a domain control to a existing domain. So when already you are having a one domain and you are creating a one more domain there, so you can select this part. And if it is like a domain new the existing forest, if you are having already a one forest and you are adding this domain under the forest, you can select this option. And this the third option is like add a new forest. So I am going to build a new forest, or you can say I'm gonna build a new domain. So that will be I will put it my name harvansh.com. why it is? Because already I am having one lab is running with the once.com name. So let me click on next. Okay, now here you give the password to restore if there is any problem, and your directory service restore mode. If you gonna restore your directory services, then you have to use this password. So guys, be careful while putting any of the password. I'm giving a password here. Now click on next, and now It's showing the dedication DNS cannot be because of the authority domain cannot found. It's okay. Click on next. And it will take few times. So my NetBIOS domain name will be Harvansh. Next. Okay, so it will be creating some few files, database folder, C drive, Windows, NTDS, and your logs folder will be under the NTDS, and sysvol folder under will be the sysvol folder. So let's click on next, and now it is showing here the details what you have configured till now. Domain name will be the harvansh.com, and the NetBIOS name is Harvansh, and the server is 2K12. And guys, if you are using 2K16 or 19, the process will be same remain as now I am showing you. So there will not be any changes to install the AD. So just I click on next, and it's showing the all prerequisite passed successfully. So there is no problem. What the prerequisite is needed, it's already there. And now we can click on the installed. So if there is any error showing to you, so you can comment me on that video so I can help you resolve that issue. Okay, so it will take some times to create that VM. Sorry, create the Active Directory. So here is the checking the Guru Policy Management Console need to be installed. And just I want to skip this part because it will take too much time to install it. And if any error comes, then I will resume it and show you guys. Or else here is no steps remaining to do any next or select anything. It will be like just okay. So now Maida is AD is installed. The server successfully configured as a domain controller. Okay, so now click on close. And click on close, automatically it will restart to configure the AD. Okay, so it getting restart, it will not take much time, it will come up fastly. It's taking just few times, it will come. Okay guys, so my machine rebooted now, and let me login it. Now you can see in it harvansh/administrator, automatically it taken that domain name. So let me login here with the domain name. Okay, so now my AD is created successfully, there is no issue, and now we can check it. Let me go first this computer property, and here is my lab machine automatically added to domain because it's a AD. Okay, so this my lab is already added to domain at the once.com. So now this AD is completely installed, and we can see how we can open it. I can close this. Now here you go and type the Active Directory, active Active Directory domain and the user and the computers. So you can go here. Here you will get the your Active Directory console. So as it is a lab and the fresh installation, so we don't have the much details here. I can see under the computer my machines. Okay, so under the domain controller it's came here. So when you added any of the machines in domain, automatically by default it will comes under the computers. If it is a, like a DC domain controller, so it will show here, and all the users will show here, all the groups by default whatever created here, so it can be seen here. Or if you want to create any users and for your lab's purpose, you can create here and you can give the rights. So now this part is done, and I can this is for the your Active Directory installation. So guys, I think hope so it clear to you how we can install the Active Directory to build our lab. Okay guys, so thank you for watching this video. See you soon in my the next video. So how we can create the user account and the other things. Okay guys, thank you so much.